Hi, I'm Max Savory. Welcome to the video highlight of our research to be published on biotechnology and bioengineering. We developed DNA aftermath for Proteus mirabilis using in silico maturation technique. Proteus mirabilis is a bacteria which causes capsid-associated urinary tract infection. When it infected to patient who's using a urethral capsid, it forms crystalline biofilm on the capsid surface and block the capsid. Because this causes more serious situations, we need early diagnosis of Proteus infection. So we think the aftermath can be used for such applications like biosensor development. So first, we identified aftermath for Proteus mirabilis by 6 rounds of cell selects, but identified aftermath also bound to other uropathogenic bacteria. So we worked on in silico maturation to improve aftermath specificity for Proteus mirabilis. In silico maturation is our original technique to improve aftermath function based on genetic algorithms. We started in silico maturation with 5 aftermath sequences that we selected by cell selects, and those sequences were crossed over and mutated in silico to produce 20 different sequences. Then we actually synthesized those sequences to test their binding specificity for Proteus mirabilis in vitro experiment. We selected aftermath with more specificity to use for the next round of in silico maturation. And after 2 cycles of in silico maturation, we successfully identified aftermath with more specificity, and it was 36% higher than original aftermath. So we can say in silico maturation succeeded in improvement of aftermath specificity for Proteus mirabilis.
We have been working on in silico maturation of many other aftermaths for different targets, and this study is the first report on improvement of aftermath specificity using in silico maturation. And also it's the first report on aftermaths for Proteus mirabilis. And we believe those aftermaths for Proteus could be used for biosensor development. And now we are currently working on the development of biosensors for diagnosis of Proteus infection. For more details, please enjoy reading our paper, and we are very happy to answer any questions by email. Thank you.